this debate up to 6 minutes, please, Mr. Simpson.
Thank you very much. This has been a good debate, but one that we brought with a collective heavy heart. That it was felt necessary to bring this motion to Parliament is testament to the way this government treats its citizens with disdain and derision. Last week there was a members' debate on this subject with no contribution from the SNP, save from a rambling and embarrassing performance by the Minister, Joe Fitzpatrick. Claire Adamson was clearly watching something else. And I can tell Claire Adamson that there was palpable anger after that performance, and that is what's led to this debate today. Now, I want to pick up... something that Mr. Fitzpatrick said right at the start of this debate, and it's quite concerning. He seemed to be suggesting that the very fact that we have an information commissioner means, in his words, that there is an ongoing independent inquiry. Now, that is not what this motion is calling for, certainly.
Joe Fitzpatrick.
Just to be clear, what I said was the Information Commissioner's actions were an independent inquiry. The Information Commissioner is independent, and the Information Commissioner is taking action after having looked at our performance, and that is an ongoing process.
Graham Simpson.
Her actions are not an independent inquiry. What this motion calls for is something entirely different. Right. It is separate from the Information Commissioner. That's what Parliament will be voting on. Now, it is encouraging that the Scottish Government have accepted the need for that review and for post-legislative scrutiny, but they've been dragged kicking and screaming to that point. The background to this debate is, of course, the open letter signed by 23 journalists expressing grave concerns about the way FOI has been handled by this government. That was mentioned by Neil Findlay, Alex Rowley and Jamie Green. And as Edward Mountain said in his opening speech, they complained of information requests being repeatedly delayed beyond the 20-day deadline, emails asking for updates being ignored, delays leading to appeals to the Scottish Information Commissioner, requests being blocked for tenuous reasons and being screened for political damage. And we had it confirmed just earlier that special advisers are involved in that process. They called for a review, and in our demand for an inquiry, so do we, as well as post-legislative scrutiny, a transparency double lock. Against this background, it may surprise Parliament to learn that the Scottish Government believes it is a beacon of transparency, and that we have in Scotland something called an Open Government National Action Plan. The problem we have here is that giving evasive answers is in this government's DNA. Now, I ask colleagues for examples. Brian Whittle has given some today, as has Jamie Green. But here's a stonker from Liam Kerr. To ask the Scottish Government what the budgeted ongoing costs were for Edinburgh Gateway Station and what the actual ongoing maintenance costs have been. Mr. Kerr got an enlightening reply from Humza Yousaf. The operational and maintenance costs for individual stations on the ScotRail network is commercially sensitive information. One of our researchers asked under FOI for information about work done on Scotland and Brexit. There were four lengthy questions. If Mr. Stevenson can stop chuntering, I'll get on with my speech. Essentially asking for details of meetings and correspondence on the potential implications of the UK leaving the EU on Scotland's long-run economic performance. The answer, we don't have those records. That has been the modus operandi of this government when dealing with questions. The way freedom of information is treated by this government amounts to censorship worthy of a totalitarian state. But I suppose, why would a government be open with its people when it thinks it is the people? Maybe recent democratic events will help dissuade them of that delusory state of mind. When the FOI Act became law, we might have thought we in Scotland were being advanced. Not so. Scotland is a comparatively recent convert to FOI, with the world's first freedom of information law happening in Sweden in 1766. The Scottish Public Information Forum, which was meant to enable the long-term effectiveness of freedom of information, and the Environmental Information Scotland regulations didn't meet for over 6 years, from 2010, until being reconvened by the Campaign for Freedom of Information Scotland. It will next meet on the 28th of September, International Right to Know Day. I'm not sure if the Scottish Government is celebrating that day. Now, we on these benches welcome the Scottish Government's new commitment to publishing all information released under Freedom of Information. The test will still be how quickly answers are given and whether the cloak of secrecy surrounds them. The SNP government has only responded to 38% of FOI requests with a full release of the information requested. They need to do better. Finally, I'd like to remind the Chamber of the words of the then Deputy First Minister, Jim Wallace, mentioned by Pauline McNeill, during the 2002 debate on the Freedom of Information Bill. He said, "Information is the currency of an open democratic society." Mr. Wallace was right in 2002. We now need a government which holds to his words.
That concludes the debate on.